We're in Moscow tonight. We're here to interview the president of Russia, Vladimir Putin. We'll be doing that soon. There are risks to conducting an interview like this, obviously. So we've thought about it carefully over many months. Here's why we're doing it. First, because it's our job. We're in journalism.
No, you're not. That's not your job at all. You don't even technically work for a place that pretends to be journalism anymore. You make a show. That's fine. I also make a show. That doesn't make me a foreign correspondent or whatever. You do a thing. And that, by the way, is a lie. That's not why you're talking. I mean, you're not doing it because of some sort of obligation, and you didn't think long and hard about the risks of it. You thought, well, if I continue to function as a useful idiot for the Russian government, then some right-wingers here will like that. Maybe I'll be given some money from foreign sources. Maybe I'll just get some more cred on the right because for some reason, everything Putin does is supposed to be awesome. That's the reason that you're doing it. And he's gonna try to couch it in concerns over how we're being unfair to Russia. Take a look at this.
This war has utterly reshaped the global military and trade alliances. And the sanctions that followed have as well. And in total, they have upended the world economy. The post-World War II economic order, the system that guaranteed prosperity in the West for more than 80 years, is coming apart very fast, and along with it, the dominance of the US dollar. These are not small changes, they are history-altering developments. They will define the lives of our grandchildren. Most of the world understands this perfectly well, they can see it. Ask anyone in Asia or the Middle East what the future looks like. And yet the populations of the English-speaking countries seem mostly unaware. They think that as nothing has really changed. And they think that because no one has told them the truth. Their media outlets are corrupt. They lie to their readers and viewers. And they do that mostly by omission.
Speaking of which, we all know that Tucker Carlson willingly lied to his audience for years about what he thought about the most important topics facing the right. Literally about Donald Trump. Tucker Carlson despised Donald Trump, but he knew that if he was honest to his audience, they would leave him. They would flee him. He would not have their support anymore. So he lied by omission to them. He lied. By the way, in court cases, Fox News' defense of Tucker Carlson's statements was that his is not a show where he states facts. He does like creative, entertaining exaggeration. That's what he does. The legal defense of him is that he is not a journalist. He is not someone that you need to take seriously. In fact, he's someone who there would be no reason to take him seriously, so he cannot be held liable for the things that he says. So to try to couch what he's doing right now as supposedly being about journalism is absolutely ridiculous. And he always does what he did in that clip. He always says, I'm gonna provide you secret information, and it's really important what I'm talking about. All of these things that are happening are really important, but he leaves out critical parts of it. So if all of this global chaos economically is the result of this war, should you not be interested in the starting of it? Bear in mind, he does not care about Ukraine. He doesn't care about the invasion. He doesn't care even about the Russians who have died in the invasion. You could have a person who would have a difficult, hard-hitting interview with Vladimir Putin trying to force him to explain why he launched this insane, illegal invasion replete with war crimes, why he's been so willing to sacrifice the lives of literally tens of thousands of his compatriots. But that is not what you're gonna get here. And you might think, as Tucker Carlson will try to make you think, well, at least we have him. I mean, nobody's trying to interview Vladimir Putin. That is simply not true. In response to Tucker Carlson saying that no Western journalists have tried to interview him, literally the press secretary for Vladimir Putin says, no, they sometimes try to, we just haven't done it. They don't want a critical interview of Vladimir Putin. They receive requests, they deny them, but they did not deny this one. And why is that? Well, you'll see when the footage comes out. It's because there will not be a question that is anything harder than Putin's soft. It is going to be propaganda produced at the behest of the Russian government to benefit the Russian government. That's what it is. It's not some like rebel, renegade truth teller being willing to do what no one else will. He's doing what no one else is allowed to do because he's going to do it the way an authoritarian leader wants it to be done. Sharon, what do you think?
And
as an actual journalist, what do you think?
Stop telling us, Tucker, that there's a risk to you being over there. You're not at risk. As long as you stick to the talking points, Putin's talking points, you're not gonna end up in a cell alongside Alexei Navalny. right? You'll just be Tucker chatting it up and eating Russian caviar with Putin. And we won't even have to talk about what you mentioned, John, how the war started or anything. This is preposterous. He's not quite a comedian. That's not really what Fox was saying, but he's not a journalist. It's like that thing in the middle where you kind of just dance and party, you know, eat a few bonbons, but you're not delivering any information and you're certainly not telling the truth. And I don't know how long he's going to be over there. Maybe the Sandy Hook denier is with him again. Maybe they'll do several shows. I don't know. But this is not journalism, and he's not in danger as long as he sticks to the talking points.
100%. I just want to read one more tweet because the right is going to love everything that he says. He's going to they love Putin. They love the anti-LGBT campaign that he's gone on. They think of him as a strong man. They want a dictator. That is why Tucker Carlson does interviews with dictators, fawning interviews with dictators, because the right wants a dictator. They love the idea of normalizing the idea that a strong man comes in and does whatever he wants, so long as he's doing it to people that you already don't like. And he's not alone. So Glenn Greenwald tweeted, who are the American journalists who conducted even minimally adversarial interviews with Zelensky? To which Elon Musk replied, to be fair, it's hard for them to talk while giving a blowjob at the same time. So it is fairly clear what these two powerful and influential men, one of whom happens to be the richest man in the world, think about this. They hate the fact that Ukraine has not been crushed. They find it to be so inconvenient. They want this to not be a topic of discussion anymore. They wanted the Ukrainian government to fall, the Ukrainian people to be decimated, Putin to completely take it over, perhaps absorb it into Russia, so we can move on to other stuff. They don't like the idea that even if we don't necessarily agree with everything about Zelensky or about Ukrainian society, they have been invaded. I'm sorry that you don't like that. But when one country invades another, the one that's invaded generally gets to be the good guy in that story because they're the ones desperately fighting for their lives. They just hate the fact that they haven't willingly laid down and died. That's what they want. And so they're going to lie about Tucker Carlson and his propagandistic faux journalism to make that point for them.